reverse it all the way out to center to Cam Atkinson. 16th straight for Cam without a goal. Big hit on Frost by Trenin. Frost is injured. That had all the looks of a boarding that might be a major. And that's a big man. 6'2", over 200 pounds. Trenin, who barreled into Frost right there.
Frost may have hit his head up against the glass as well. The question will be is, you know, were the numbers presented early enough? Absolutely. Those numbers are there long.
Nashville long number 13. 2 minutes for legal check to the head.
2 minutes.
Well, let's see where the contact is made.
It's just where the player is on the ice.
To me, it's more of an issue of boarding. Yeah.
He doesn't hit him in the head. His head
hits the glass because he's unsuspecting that he's going to get hit. Well, puck's gone, too. It's late.
I mean, I have not been able to figure out the penalty calls on the boarding sometimes. Some of them. This one looked pretty bad. I mean, he came quite a ways.
Yeah, there's no way, there's no reason
the
to finish that hit.
It's a major penalty.
It will now be reviewed.
So
they changed it to a major. They said 2 minutes. Yeah, he did.
But there's no reason to finish your hit there because the numbers are presented well in advance. Like, you see the 48 for, I mean, it's in slow-mo, so hard to tell how long it is, but it's not like Frost turned at the last second. At that point, you got to give a break to. Now, look, McCarron's closest. He doesn't finish him. Here's Trenin. He's got him lined up. To me, that's a boarding. That's a five-minute major boarding penalty.
Well, it's the one there's been much discussion about in the NHL this year, that we're seeing more of these, a lot more they're talking about for defensemen who go back and get boarded. This was a forward more in the middle of the ice, but the bottom line is it's the same situation. Player had time to certainly let up a little.
Yeah, he didn't have to finish him the way he did. Take a look at it, real speed. Now, I mean, I guess if I'm playing devil's advocate, Trenin certainly could have hit him a lot harder than he did. Slow-mo looks a little worse. At real speed, he didn't, wasn't like he took a couple strides and plastered him. I mean, this might be a little bit more difficult to call a major in the sense that he does finish him, but it's not like he drives right through him.
So Frost has gone back to the locker room.
I think it's prudent, though, that they call a five so that they can review it.
Oh, yeah, this has definitely been a good thing instituted by the league so that they can look at it, get it right, because when you're dealing with a major penalty, it can have a major impact on the game. So I think it's important they get it right and get as many looks as possible, and that's just what the two officials are doing right now. And while they do that, we tell you about Christmas Day. After the presents are open, settle down and watch the Eagles take on the Giants. Coverage starts at 3. With Birds Huddle Game Day, followed by Eagles pregame live, right here on NBC Sports Philadelphia and streaming on the NBC Sports app.
You know, JJ, as I look at it again in real speed, it makes me want to change my thought about a major. I just feel like maybe in slow-mo it should be a major because it looks so obvious. But in real speed, I don't think he drives through him like I initially thought. I think he does in some ways ease up. I don't think he should have hit him at all. I think I'm going to change my decision and say 2 minutes. That's my opinion. They're looking at it long and hard. We'll see. I mean,
Trenin's an honest hockey player. Likes to hit, obviously.
Yeah, he plays a physical game.
His first NHL fight was with Big Z, Zdenochar, and he knocked Big Z down in that fight. But this hit, and that's his game. Making contact, but when you see two numbers and you have him lined up for that long,
it'll be interesting.
You don't need to hit him.
I think he could have hit him harder if he wanted to, and he could have eased up if he wanted to. That's why I say I think 2 minutes is probably the call. I don't know the fact that they're looking at it even longer, if that's good news or bad news.
Yeah, that means it's a tough call.
Yeah.
Which is what you said. The result certainly looked like a major. The player was bloodied, his head rattled against the glass, but it's possible he got him a little from the side as well as from behind, and as you say, he didn't completely finish the check, but still enough impact there. I mean, that's still pretty heavy hit, Bruce. I don't know. From that angle, it looks bad. I don't know.
How much of the responsibility is on the guy getting hit as well? I mean, yeah. You know, Torch talked about this last week.
It's true. Here we go.
After video review, the call on the ice, we have a 5-minute major and a game misconduct for boarding.
Okay.
So that's the end of Trenin for the rest of this game. And the Flyers with a big opportunity here, much to the chagrin of Andrew Brunette. But this is a huge chance here. 5 minutes of power play time.
It's not the first time I'm wrong. It won't be the last.
Well, it's not necessarily you're wrong. You just disagree with their call.
Well, I mean, I'm just saying it was my opinion. And looking at it at real speed.
The fact that it took that long shows you that.